The American Academy of Pediatrics came out today with the recommendation that students ages 2 and up should still wear masks when schools open back up in the fall. They say masks at school should be required for all students because most school-aged children still are not eligible to get the vaccine. Joining us now to talk more about the mask debate is Dr. Kaveh Bahmanpour with Sharp Community Medical Group. Thank you for joining us.
Hi, Kathleen.
Well, we are just weeks away, as you know, from the first day of school, and we're getting this news. COVID cases are surging. In your medical opinion, is masking up inside the classroom necessary and the way to go here?
Well, American Academy of Pediatrics, basically, they look at the data and they suggested that that's the way it needs to go. And they're the ones who actually came up with their recommendations. And we follow their recommendations. I have teenagers and I have 10-year-old as well. So just from the scientific standpoint, that seems to be reasonable to send our kids to school with masks and we can protect them. I mean, there's no any other way around it. Pfizer suggested that there will be a vaccine probably in winter. FDA also approved that it's going to come out, which is going to vaccinate 5 to 11-year-old. And the vaccine is going to be less amount in there. I think it's going to be 10 microgram of the vaccine in that, but the data is going to come out in September. So we're not going to have any vaccine for under 12-year-old kids until like late winter probably. So there's no any other way around to help those kids not to get infection.
Well, let me ask you this then, because children were generally believed to be not as impacted by COVID-19. Is the Delta variant presenting a different case? Are children more susceptible of contracting the virus and more vulnerable?
So children can get the infection more like adults. There's no problem with that. And in fact, their infection is not going to be as bad as adults. The problem is they can spread it in the community. The kid can get it at the school and they can spread it. And they can be some centers that they actually bring more to the community. So that's what we are worried about more than anything else, because one kid in a school can basically contaminate all the other kids in the school and in the class, and that would be a problem. And we are really doing a great job with vaccination and wearing masks in our community and bringing the COVID infection down in our community. Now that Delta is back, we see there is a surge, and we don't want that come back to our community.
Well, doctor, let me ask you this, because there's certainly been a lot of mask confusion up to now, and this seems to kind of add to it. Why is the American Academy of Pediatrics recommending masks inside the classroom, but the CDC says we don't need to wear masks indoors if we're vaccinated?
Yeah, well, actually, the case is just for the kids. So because the kids, we don't have any vaccination for the kids under 12-year-old. If they were vaccinated, that would be a different story. But since we don't have any vaccine for kids and we don't have any other way to protect them from not getting infection, so it seems to be reasonable to have them masked, but we have to see as it goes. So the COVID case is basically changing and evolving day after day. Who knows what's going to be the next recommendation in a few months, but for now it seems to be a right move to have kids if they want to get back to school, and I think they should get back to a school because they have to have that like in-person education versus staying home. But if they want to get back to school with the COVID surge that we are seeing coming back, it seems to be a right move to have like the kids wearing masks inside the classes too. I'm hoping that in the winter, probably next year, we have more vaccines available for even kids to be available under 12-year-olds. So we'll see what's going to happen at that time.
Well, we're seeing a widening gap these days between the vaccinated and the unvaccinated. What is your message to the parents who might be watching right now who either themselves don't want to get the vaccine or give it to their children?
Well, I strongly recommend everyone to get vaccine. We don't have any other tool. We don't have any other medication to prevent this infection. And we are all in this together. So I'm hoping that whoever, even one person can hear my voice today, can go and get the vaccine if I can change their mind. Because the data that we see, even if you get the infection, I mean, there are some cases that you were vaccinated and got the infection, but the chances of getting to the hospital or the infection get to the point that you're really having trouble is less and less. 97% of the hospitalization is from the people who haven't been vaccinated. So I would like to see if any, I recommend it to all my patients, regardless of the risk factor, regardless of the any other comorbidity, I would strongly recommend to get vaccinated.
Dr. Bahmanpour, on that note, we will let you go. Thank you so much for your time and insight.
My pleasure. Thank you, Kathleen.